There just may be a silver lining for Baduk or Go Grandmaster Lee Se-dol as he seeks to overtake Google's AlphaGo again in their final of the five-match series tomorrow. Now, this time, coming off a historic fourth-round win, the human player may have the upper hand after the supercomputer revealed a weak spot. Our Kim Ji-yeon has more on this high-profile matchup that's grabbed the world's attention.
Google's AI program AlphaGo may not be the infallible supercomputer we all thought it was, especially after Baduk Grandmaster Lee Se-dol's win on Sunday. Game 4 unfolded just like their second game last week, until the 11th move by Lee Se-dol. AlphaGo seemed to scramble after that as the game headed into uncharted territory, with the computer making questionable decisions with moves 79 and 87. Professional players were left scratching their heads.
I was a little confused when AlphaGo put its stone there. The move made it less likely it would win.
About an hour before the end of the match, AlphaGo's developer Demis Hassabis tweeted that AlphaGo was unlikely to win four straight games, as its chances nosedive after move 87. By placing a stone between AlphaGo's two stones, Lee Se-dol held AlphaGo's stones captive while freeing its prison stones simultaneously.
I haven't really put any deep thought into why I made move 87. At the time, it just seemed like it was the only way to carry on. I didn't know it would be such a critical moment.
Grandmaster Lee's instinct to choose strategic moves may be something AlphaGo has yet to master, as it mainly relies on calculating winning chances of each move on the Baduk grid. Their final round in the best-of-five competition is slated for Tuesday, 1 p.m. Korea time, with Grandmaster Lee playing the black stones and AlphaGo playing the white. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.